Hello. Chapter 4, Introduction of Living Things. Section 1, Everything is Connected. Section 2, Living Things Need Energy. Section 3, Interaction Between Organisms. Section 3, because we have already finished Section 1 and Section 2. Section 1, Everything is Connected. Section 2, Living Things Need Energy. Alright. We are going to learn those objectives. Explain the relationship between carrying capacity and limiting factors. Describe two types of competition. Distinguish between mutualism, commensalism, and parasitism. Alright, type of interactions. Everything in the environment affect every other thing's population, also affect every other population. That means living things affect each other. Because there is food, there is water, there is oxygen, there is place they are using in same places. Most living things produce more offspring, that means babies or youngs, than will survive. The female frog, for example, may lay hundreds of eggs in small pond, meaning source of water. In a few months, the population of frogs in that pond will be about the same as it was the year before. Why won't the pond become overrun with frogs? An organism such as a frog interacts with the biotic and abiotic factors. Biotic factors, as you remember, living factors. What about abiotic, non-living factors? Example of biotic, for example, animals, plants. What about abiotic, water, temperature, soil, rock? In the environment, that can control the size of its population. Limiting factors. Population cannot grow without stopping because the environment contains a limited amount of food, water, living space, and other resources. A resource that's so scarce it limits size of population is called limiting factors. Carrying capacity. The largest population that an environment can support, known as the carrying capacity. When a population grows larger than its carrying capacity, limiting factors in the environment cause individuals to die or live. For example, a source of water here. It is enough for 100 animals, but there is 1,000 animals. What happened? Some animals will die or live or move another places to find another ecosystem. As individuals die or live, the population decreases. A limiting factor will cause the population to die back. The population will return to size that environment can support. Carrying capacity is the largest population that an environment can support at any given time. Interaction between organisms. Population contain individual of single species that interact with another such as a group of rabbit feeding in the same area. Ecologists have described three main ways that species individuals affect each other: competition, predators, and prey, and symbiotic relationships. There are three effects: competition, predators, and prey, symbiotic relationships. Alright, we have a question to solve together. Which of the following is not one of the main ways organisms affect one another? There are three main ways. Remember them. What are they? Competition, predators, and prey, symbiotic relationships. According to that, the answer will be, of course, D. When two or more individuals or population try to use the same resources, such as food, water, shelter, space, or sunlight, even meat, is called competition. Competition happens between individuals within a population, also between population. The different species of trees in figure 2, as you see here, are competing with each other for sunlight and space, because living things, especially producers, need sunlight to make their own food. Predators and prey. Many interactions between species consist of organism eating another. Prey, an organism that is killed and eaten by another organism. Predator, an organism that eats all or part of another organism. When a bird, as you see bird here, when a bird eats worm, bird eats worm, as you see here, bird eats worm, the worm will be prey, the bird will be predator. Predator adaptation. To survive, predator must be able to catch their food or their prey because they need energy to survive. Every living thing needs energy. So, predator needs energy also. So, they are going to eat prey. Predator have a wide variety of methods and abilities for doing so. The cheetah, for example, is able to run very quickly to catch its prey. The cheetah going to catch the deer, for example. Predators such as the goldenrod spider, shown in figure 3, and bush their prey. The goldenrod spider blend in so well with the goldenrod flower that all it has to do is wait for next insect to meal to survive. That means they are waiting for their food or prey. Prey adaptation. Prey have their own method and ability to keep from being eaten. Prey are able to run away. For example, deer running away from cheetah. Stay in group, they stay together, or camouflage themselves. Some prey are poisons, like some snakes or frogs. Prayer dogs run their underground burrows when predator approach. Camouflage. One way animals avoid being eaten is by being hard to see. For example, it is very hard to see what rabbit. Here also, there is a kind of insect. It is look like a piece of wood, but it is what? Insect. So it is kind of camouflage. Alright, so camouflage, it is very important for prey to run away from predator. Defensive chemicals. Some animals defend themselves with the chemicals. The song and the bombardier battle. Both spray predator with the irritating chemicals. Bees, ants, and wasps inject a powerful acid into their attackers to predator. Any predator that eats or try to eat one of these animals will likely die. So they're example of defensive chemicals. They have poisons they are using for to protect themselves. Warning coloration. Animals that have chemical defenses need a way to warn predator that they should look elsewhere for a meal. Their chemical weapons are often adversite by warning colors. As shown in figure 5, the predator will avoid any animals that has the color and patterns. They then associated with the pain, illness, or unpleasant experience. As you see, when the animals, for example, snake, see that kind of frogs, it is red, so they are not worried about the colors. So they are not going to catch them. Symbiosis. I told you before, symbiosis is very important for that section. You have to know symbiosis very well. What is symbiosis? Some species have very close interaction with other species. The individual in symbiotic relationship can benefit from, yani there are two living things living together. They get benefit from each other or be unaffected, or they are living together. They cannot get benefit, or they harm, they destroy each other, or this one of them destroy another one. The thousands of symbiotic relationship relationships in nature are often classified in three main groups. What are they? Mutualism, commensalism, and parasitism. There are three kind of symbiosis. What are they? Mutualism, commensalism, and parasitism. Mutualism, two living things live together, a symbiotic relationship in which both organism benefit called mutualism. There are two living things live together, both of them get benefit. Both of them help each other. For example, you and a species of bacteria that live in your intestine benefit each other. For example, in our liver, there is million kind of bacteria. That bacteria surviving your body. It is going to be your defense system. So bacteria defend your intestine, your body, your stomach. Also, you are feeding them. You get benefit from bacteria because bacteria surviving from you, from germs, from microbes. What about you? You are giving them food. So both of them, bacteria and human being, get benefit. The bacteria get food from you, is it? And you get vitamins that the bacteria produce. That means vitamins meaning produce or fight with diseases. Both organisms benefit from this relationship. Yani bacteria get benefit, human being get benefit. Commensalism, a symbiotic relationship in which one organism benefit and the other is unaffected. There are two organisms, one of them get benefit, the other unaffected. Example of commensalism is relationship between shark and smaller fish called remors in figure 7, but I didn't put figure here. Maybe I will show you in figure in the future. Figure 7 shows a shark with a remora attached its body. Remoras hit a right and feed on scraps of food left by sharks. The remoras benefit from this relationship while sharks are unaffected. The small fish get benefit from the big fish, but for big fish it is nothing. Here, as you see, let me show you here. Sorry. Here, there is big fish and small fish. Small fish eating something here, get food. But for shark, for big fish, it is non-affected. It doesn't matter. The small fish get benefit, but large, that means shark, do not get any what? Affected. Again, let us check again. Symbiosis, a relationship in which two different organisms live in close association with each other, yani living together. Mutualism, a relationship between two species in which both species get benefit. Both of them get benefit. Commensalism, a relationship between two organisms in which one organism get benefit and other is unaffected. Small fish get benefit from large fish, but for large fish unaffected. Do not get any affected. Parasitism, a symbiosis association in which one organism benefit while the other harm is called parasitism. There are two living things live together. For example, like worm or mosquitoes. Mosquito get blood or food from human being and destroy it. That means when mosquitoes bit the human being, get food and make diseases human being. Which kind of diseases? Malaria. Alright. Symbiosis association which one organism benefit while the other harm is called parasitism, or harm or destroy. The organism that benefit is called parasite. That means mosquito is parasite. The organism that is harm is called host. Human being is host. The parasite get nutrition, that means food, from its host, while the host weakened. The human get diseases. Which kind of disease? Malaria. Other parasites such as tapeworms, some worms also living in our human body. Also what happened? It is eating food from us. and making some diseases. Alright, here for example, worm eating what? Plants. Eating plant, get food from plant and destroy what? Destroy the plant. Alright, let us make summary of that section. Limiting factors in the environment keep a population from growing without limit. Two or more individual or population try to use the same resource is called competition. Predator is an organism that eats all or part of another organism. The organism eaten is called prey. Prey have developed features such as camouflage, chemical defenses, and warning coloration or protect them from predators. Symbiosis, don't forget symbiosis. There are three kinds of symbiosis. What are they? Mutualism, commensalism, and parasitism. Symbiosis occurs when two organisms form a very close relationship with one and another. Option review. Question 1. In your own word, write a definition for the carrying capacity, the largest population that an environment can support for a long time is known as carrying capacity. If I ask in final exam that question, it is going to be answered for you. Question 2. Use each of the following terms in separate sentence. What are they? Mutualism, commensalism, and parasitism. Firstly, mutualism, a symbiotic relationship in which both organisms get benefit. Commensalism, a symbiotic relationship in which organism benefit and the other is unaffected. For example, in mutualism, there are two living things, both of them get benefit. In commensalism, there are two living things, one of them get benefit, the other non-affect. In parasitism, a symbiotic relationship in which one organism benefit while the other is harmed, that means destroyed. The organism that benefit is called parasite. The organism is harmed or destroyed is called host. Question 3. Which one of the following is not a pre-adaptation? There are three of them, remember them. Camouflage, chemical defenses, warning coloration, parasitism. Parasitism, it is kind of symbiotic. What is parasitism? Which one organism get benefit while the other is harmed? The organism that benefit is called parasite. The organism that is harmed or destroyed is called host. Question 4. Identify two things organism compete with one another for. Organism compete with one another for space and for resources such as food, water, or mate. Question 5. Briefly describe one example of predator-prey relationship. Identify the predator and prey. Example. A cat eats a mouse. Cat is predator and mouse is prey. As you see graph here, please focus graph very well. The population graph below shown the growth of species paramecium. Paramecium kind of single cell. Over 80 days, the food was added to test tube. Use the graph and to answer question follow. As you see, there are three questions. What is the carrying capacity of the test tube as long as food is added? Question 7. Predict what will happen if no more food is added. Question 8. What keeps the number of paramecium at steady level? Let us solve question 6. What is question 6? What is the carrying capacity of the test tube as long as food is added? As you see, students, carrying capacity it is up to here, that level. That level meaning more than 50, but less than 100. It is around 56 or 55%. It is about going to be 55 paramecium. Alright. Question 7. Predict what will happen if no more food is added. The carrying capacity will drop and eventually all of organism will die. Because why? there is no food. If there is no food, they will die because living things need energy to survive. Question 8. What if the number of paramecium at the steady level? Limiting factors such as food supply, as you see, the limiting factors changing according to food. Alright, please write everything in your notebook and subscribe the YouTube channel.